was brought to you by Perez Tire Center, Aces Bail Bonds, Miranda & Sons Automotive, Bridgeport Auto Glass, Ramirez Spanish Restaurant, Tito's Barbershop, JC Tire Center, Rancho Patanal Brazilian Restaurant, and Luz de Paz Funeral Home.
What's up, you guys? Welcome to Super League Entertainment. It's your boy, Jason Rodriguez, and we are here live in the studio for another exclusive interview. First of all, I want to thank each and every one of you, the viewing audience, all of you guys who tune in every Tuesday night at 7 o'clock. You know we do this every Tuesday night, and we try, our goal here is to bring you the best exclusive interviews throughout the state of Connecticut. Tonight, we have a really good friend of mine, personal trainer and bodybuilder, Joel Rodriguez, in the studio for an exclusive interview. But before we get into that, there's a couple of things that I want to break down to you. I want to share with you some current events that are going to be taking place in the city of Bridgeport, Connecticut. Upcoming events, current affairs coming up in the city of Bridgeport, Connecticut in the next couple of weeks. We have New Life Assembly of God in the town of Trumbull, Connecticut is having what's called their annual Run for Hope 5K Run, presented by New Life Assembly of God in the town of Trumbull. It's going to be starting off at Trumbull High School. All proceeds of this event is going to be going to Rescue Mission in the city of Bridgeport, Connecticut is going to benefit greatly from this event taking place next Saturday. If you're a runner, come out June 15th, Trumbull, Connecticut. Like I said, New Life Assembly of God is putting on a 5K. You don't have to run. If you want to walk, you can walk it. If you want to crawl, you can crawl it. All right? If you want to ride a bicycle, bring your bike out there. Bring whatever it is that you have that has wheels on it. Don't bring your car, though. Well, bring your car, but you can't put your car in the 5K, all right? But yeah, June 15th, Saturday in Trumbull, Run for Hope 5K, presented by New Life Assembly of God. Then, Sunday, the Fairfield County Puerto Rican Day Parade. June 14th, right here in the great city of Bridgeport, Connecticut. The parade will start at Central High School, work its way down North Avenue, Park Avenue, ending at Seaside Park in the city of Bridgeport, Connecticut, followed by a huge festival with bands playing. They're going to have Luisito Carrion, Spanish Harlem Orquesta. They're going to have the Latin Heartbeat, Rumba y Caliente. So listen, Sunday, July 14th is going to be the Puerto Rican Day Parade in the city of Bridgeport, Connecticut. I apologize for giving you that wrong date, that misinformation. Thank you to the person that's in the crowd that corrected me.
Right.
And then the following week after that, July 20th and 21st, Saturday and Sunday, the Colombians are taking over the city of Bridgeport, and they're going to be doing what's called the Independence Day for Colombia, all right? So that's going to be Saturday, Sunday, July 20th and 21st, right here in the city of Bridgeport, Connecticut at Seaside Park. There will be performances by Nelson Vasquez, Florentino, Pedro Arroyo, and so many others. There will be tons of food vendors. So come out and attend this great event. Free event. Puerto Rican Day Parade, free. The Colombian Festival, free. All right, so come out and participate and be a part of what's going on. Now, the 5K run with New Life Assembly of God, not free. You have to register it and you have to donate some money. But I guarantee you that the money that you donate, those proceeds will go towards a good cause. All right. Also, I want to mention Tuesday, August 6th, you guys that are watching right now, we have what's being called the National Night Out 2019, taking place in the city of Bridgeport, Connecticut. Tuesday, August 6th from 5:30 to 7:30, an event that brings police officers, which of course is the Bridgeport Police Department, and also brings together the community in a fun environment so that you can see that, you know, not every officer is a bad person. The news and the media sometimes make police officers look like they're bad, but you know, not every officer is dirty, not every police officer is bad. So come out Tuesday, August 6th from 5:30 to 7:30, right here in Bridgeport, Connecticut, and we're going to be having that event at 695 Park Avenue in Bridgeport at the Illinois apartment. For more information, visit National Lights Out 2019 on Eventbrite. All right, the last thing I want to mention, as you can see on our list of topics, is starting at the end of this month, new for 2019, is the return of the Super Elite Entertainment Boxing Show. It's a show that we did and we have for quite some time, interviewing boxers, breaking down analysis and commentary of upcoming fights and events and anything that's relating to the sport of boxing. Coming up the end of this month, that show will be returning right here on this network, the Super Elite Entertainment Broadcasting Network. And the person that will be joining me on that panel will be a good friend of mine who works for the WWE in Stamford, Connecticut, Evan Smith. He will be my co-host on that show, and that show will be starting towards the end of this month. So stay tuned for what's to come. I guarantee you're going to enjoy it. All right. Now, with that said, we have tonight a really good friend of mine, as I stated in the beginning, Mr. Joel Rodriguez, who's a personal trainer. He's a bodybuilder. The dude's a beast. If you don't know him, oh, you're going to know him tonight. He's going to pop those pecs all over the... Hold on, let me see. You see my pecs? You see anything?
I do.
I got people in the audience laughing. That's terrible. Hold on, let me see. I'm going to show you my muscle first before Joel comes in here. I got a little something.
You lean.
But with that said, I have Joel Rodriguez in the studio tonight for part two. The reason why I say part two is because he was here before, previously in the studio, and we had a great time with him. And the reason why we invited him for part two is because the ratings of that episode that we did with him went sky high. So many people tuned in, so many people were watching, and you know, so many people had questions that night when we were live on Facebook, YouTube, and Periscope, and we're going to do it all over again tonight. So with that said, I'm going to bring into the picture Mr. Joel Rodriguez.
Hey, what's up, brother? Thank you for having me, man. I appreciate it.
Yo,
I mean, I can't start the show like this, man.
Bam! Hold on. Let me change that angle of the camera. Hit it again. Boom!
That was go time. So, yeah, I appreciate it. Thank you for having me, man.
Yo, definitely, man. So, Joel, how's everything, man? How you doing?
I'm blessed, man. I'm living. Busy. Life is good.
Excellent, man. So, this is part two.
Yeah, part two. Let's work.
Part two. We had part one in the beginning of the year when I first debuted the show. Right. And you were one of the first guests to come on the show at our old location.
Right.
And now you're here in the new studio. So you got to, first of all, you got to tell me, what do you think about the new spot?
It's beautiful, man. It's awesome. It's amazing. I feel honored again to be here for the second time. And I appreciate you and your accomplishments, man. It speaks for itself, man. I'm proud of you, man.
Thank you, man. Thank you.
This is awesome.
Thank you, man. And I'm honored to have you here again.
Thank you.
And, you know, last show we did was a hit. It was a hit. A lot of people watched. A lot of people shared it onto their timeline. And if you watch it right now, I you know, strongly encourage you to share this live broadcast onto your timeline, especially if you know me and Joel Rodriguez.
Two
Rodriguez's from the city of Bridgeport, Connecticut.
That's right.
Born and raised in the east side, in the hood. Father Panda Village.
Yep.
East Main Street.
Hallett Street.
Johnson, where else?
Jane.
Pembroke.
Oh,
you
man,
know, James Street.
The real east side. Now, I don't know what it is.
I don't know if I should mention Cassoo Street because I used to not be on no Cassoo Street.
Not me neither.
Pike de la Bonne. Yeah, so Joel, I'm excited to have you here, man.
I'm excited to be here, man.
You know, a couple of things that I want to ask you. We're going to jump right into it, brother. And my first question is for you, Joel. So, looking at you, looking at your size, just looking at you, we can tell that you take health and fitness very, very serious.
Oh, man, that's my priority, man. That's
it's not a game.
Not a game.
So my first question for you is, why do you put yourself through all the agony to look the way you look right now?
Well, you know, it's just a goal that I had. And, you know, I come from a line in my family. A lot of them are diabetics, you know. And I'm trying to avoid all that. Mm-hmm. I see what it does, and I don't want to be like that. And plus, I love what I do, man. This is my calling. Mm-hmm. My calling is to help others. I am my own billboard.
Yeah.
If I can't preach health and then look a different way. Unfortunately, we live in a world where you get judged by your parents.
Uh-huh.
I mean, I can be out of shape and know what I'm talking about, but nobody's going to want to do anything I tell them or do any type of work with me if I'm out of shape.
Yeah.
So, but I love it, man. Pain, I love it. God gave me the ability and this talent, and I believe this is my calling to help others.
You know, before we continue on with the interview,
yes.
I got to pause, and I got to show a video of you at the gym in Trumbull, Connecticut. What gym was that we went to?
LA Fitness.
LA Fitness. We recorded you while you were working out, going through your routine.
Right.
And it's a great video. So we got to show the viewing audience right now. Let's check this out, all right? Don't go anywhere after the video. I and Mr. Joel Rodriguez will be right back. But check this video out. You're going to like it. Beast Mode, Joel Rodriguez.
Working.
All right, and welcome back to Super League Entertainment. I hope you enjoy that video. Let me tell you something. One thing about Joel Rodriguez, the dude is a beast. Not only does he take care of his personal wellness and his personal body, but it's a service that he provides to many clients throughout the state of Connecticut.
Definitely.
And you know, he has people driving in from all over the place, and you know,
do home visits and
all. He's up, and he also does home visits. So again, let me bring him into the picture, Mr. Joel Rodriguez.
Hey,
yo, that video's a beast.
Yeah, I love that video. Every time it gives me chills, man. You did a great job with that, man.
Yeah,
it's perfect, man.
Well, you the one that did a great job with it. You the one that was, you know, under the influence of tearing those weights apart, man.
Well, man, you gave me confidence to do all that, man. I was actually nervous when you were recording it. I didn't think it was gonna come out that great, but you made me look good. You made me look good, man. I appreciate that.
No, definitely, man. So again, Joel, I mean, we're back, and as people just seen on that video, man, right. It's, you know, this is something that's your lifeline. This is something that you do on a daily basis. I mean, people may look at you and say, Joel, man, I mean, what is it? Do you live in a gym? I mean, so to be the way you looked, the way you look, to be in the right conditioning that you're in. And hold on, come over here. Let's compare real quick, man. Hold on. Oh God. Let me cover this up. That's terrible. Hold on. Leave it up. You gotta show the people that are watching. Let's show that bullet.
If you see it a little bit closer, you can see snow up there. You see this peaks, the mountain peaks, the snow.
Oh man. So what is the day in the life of a bodybuilder like? From the moment you wake up to the moment you lay your head down on the pillow, Joel.
Oh man, it's people think it's easy. It's not actually. You either want it or you don't want it. I go to bed thinking about my next routine the next day. Like even with clients, I see a lot of, like, as far as like trainers walk around with books. I use everything comes from my mind. I have everything written down here. I don't write nothing down unless they ask for it. Mm. But I'm always thinking of what's next. What can I do? I utilize the machines the way they should be and the way they shouldn't be. Mm-hmm. I have an orthodox of training. It's totally different than a lot of people's. I can do like 7-8 exercises on one machine that you've never seen before. Mm-hmm. And you might think it looks a little off, but it's not. You know, I mean, I look like this for a reason. I work hard, man. Yeah. And I'm not even being cocky. I have the right to act this way, uh-huh, because I love what I do and I put in the time and I'm still putting in. This ain't nothing. I haven't even begun to see changes. This is just the tip of the iceberg. It gets bigger than this.
Yeah.
Give me a few more months. You'll see a whole different person, man.
You know, so my thing with you is we grew up together.
That's right. Yeah.
We grew up in the same neighborhood.
Mm-hmm.
And when I knew you back then, you did not look anywhere compared to the way you look right now.
I was like, wow, you know? 120?
Yeah.
120, 115, if that.
Uh-huh.
That was skinny, man. I didn't think about any of this stuff ever.
So, you know, my question is, how did you get started? Because there's a lot of people out there who, when they take their clothes off at night or when they're jumping in the shower, when they look at themselves in the mirror, right, they're not happy nor impressed with their image, with the way they right look. And constantly people tell themselves, I got to do something about this. I got to do something about that, you know? And in your case, was that the way you got started? Did you look at yourself and you said, you know what? I don't like the way I look. I'm going to do something about this. And did you just jump in and get started?
Nah, actually, you know, be totally honest, like, nah, it never was like that. I never cared about any of that. Mm-hmm. I wasn't into health and all that. I mean, to get technically, like, I started many, many years ago, man. You know, when you're from Bridgeport, you guys that know us, I'm from Bridgeport. You know, I grew up in the east side of Bridgeport. And, you know, at a point in my life, I lived a foul life. And I don't need to explain what, if you know what foul means, you know what I'm saying.
Mm-hmm.
And I did some things and I got myself into some trouble and I ended up on vacation, put it like this, on vacation. I felt at the moment like the character in the Bible, like Jonah, you know.
Yep.
I was swallowed by the whale for not listening to God. I had to sit there for many, many, many years until he was ready to spit me out. And I sat there and the food they feed us and the way they treat us, it's crazy, man. Hmm. I mean, it's an experience that I don't wish on anybody. So long story short is, I see how these guys take medication because they can't face reality. A lot of them were diabetics. A lot of them would just sit around and just get overweight and take meds. Me, I refuse to be like that. I said, I'm not. I'm going to sit here. If I'm going to sit here for this until it's time for me to come home, man, I'm going to work. And I started working out, doing calisthenics. And of course you hear the negativity all the time. Oh, you're not gonna do that when you go home. And I said, watch me. Now them same people that say I wasn't gonna do that when I go home, they're the same ones asking me, how can I get like that?
The tables are turned.
Oh man, I love it because you know, you didn't believe in me. And I believed in myself. And then it just kept going. I kept going. I keep it real. Like I said, man, I'm not perfect, but now I'm in a different stage in my life. That I found my calling, believe it or not. To some people might think that it's weird. This is my calling. My calling is to help. Yes, you have to pay for my service. There's nothing free. I have family. This is how I feed my family. Mm-hmm. This is my livelihood. So right now, if you're watching, right now it's free. Ask what you want. I'm not on the clock, but advice is free. But when I got to show you and put my hands, I have to charge you. Mm-hmm. And if I could, like I said before, I would love to do this for free to help everybody, because the greatest payment for me is when somebody tells me, you changed my life. Mm. That means to me more than money, man. When somebody say, because of you, I live a certain lifestyle, because this is what it is. It is a lifestyle. Mm-hmm. It's not, it's in style today, and then it's out of, no, you either want it, you got, and it's not for everybody. Mm-hmm. So long story short, like I said, I focus. My mindset was like, I know eventually the doors, you know, I get spit out of here and I'm going to continue this. And it became, I made it into a business. Mm. So, same hustle, just different game.
Absolutely.
Same hustle, different game, man. I'm still the same person. I'm just a lot mature. And I breathe. I live this. This is my life. Fitness is my life. And you see my Instagram, that's what it says. Fitness is my life. Fitness saved my life. Mm. Because I can be in a lot of worse places. My block is the gym. I run. I live there. That's where I hang out at. Uh-huh. Without fitness, I'd probably be hanging out back where I shouldn't be. Mm-hmm. So because I discovered fitness and God introduced fitness, because that's every, without God, none of this is possible for me. Mm-hmm. So if anybody can't argue with me, or God put fitness into my life. Mm-hmm. And I am alive today and doing what I do because of God.
Absolutely.
And this is what I choose to do. So when people ask me, oh, can I work out with you, or when we gonna get a session in, some of them get offended because I don't do that.
Yeah.
I'm a certified personal trainer. Mm. This is how I make money. I'm not going to work out with you for free. I'm not going to train you for free. This, I got to pay bills. You're not going to give me a haircut for free.
You're right.
If you're a barber, you're not going to, you're a mechanic. Yo, I need you to fix my car. You're not going to fix my, it's the same thing. So it's a business.
So you're saying you do have people periodically coming up to you and trying to pick your brain and get tips for free?
I can give tips for free. Tips is, like I said, advice is free, man. I love to help people. Yo, how can, what does this work? When they ask me, what does this work? I explain to them what it works. Oh, can you show me? Nah, I got to put my hands on you. Now I got to get paid. And no disrespect to nobody. I had to write a post recently on Facebook because I kept getting messages. I need it. Oh, we need to get a workout in. I don't do this for free. And I wrote an, it was nice and they're very respectful. I don't want to dis, family pays. Mm-hmm. I charge family. Yeah. So why would I not charge you? So it is what it is. Like I said, I'm not here to be offended nobody about, because I don't want to work out. Don't take it that way. Don't take it personal. It's just business.
Yep. So that is your livelihood. Mm-hmm. That is definitely your career. That is what this you is my, do.
This is what I do.
On a day-to-day basis.
Day-to-day basis.
And you deal with your clientele. Definitely. Of all different types.
All types.
Nationalities. Doesn't matter who it is.
I don't discriminate, man. Money ain't got no gender.
They come to you for a service. And like your shirt says, you push them to that limit.
Push your limits, man. Push your limits. Because we're capable. People underestimate the mind. The mind. If you put your mind, you're capable of doing so much things. So when somebody always tell me, dude, I want to be like you, I always tell them, no, you want to be better. Mm. Never settle. You want to be better than me. And I tell them that. Mm. I don't sit there and be like, no, you can't. No, you could be. You could be better than me. That's, I don't, right, never want to be like you. I want to be better than you.
That's right.
In a respectful way. You know, I want to be, I don't need, I said it before, I don't need a rapper, a bodybuilder, professional, or to be my role model. I am my role model. I look up to myself. I don't need any of them to look up to, because I look up to myself. Mm-hmm. I am my billboard. I am my own person. Mm. And I've been through so much in life that I know I don't need that I know about life. I don't need that person to tell me, mm-hmm, oh, you should. I don't want to be like nobody. I want to be me. If, yeah, I want to be like anybody, and it'd be impossible, it'd be Jesus.
That's right.
And that's impossible. And if I could even get a little bit closer, I'd be happy.
And with that said, we're going to take a quick commercial break. All right, and for you guys that are watching, I have Mr. Joel Rodriguez, personal trainer and professional bodybuilder, here in the studio. And we're broadcasting live on Facebook and YouTube. If you haven't clicked that share button yet, please click it and share this broadcast into your timeline. And again, I'm your host, Jason Rodriguez. We're going to take a commercial break. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with Joel Rodriguez.
Take a talk.
Looking for custom wheels? Looking for quality and professional service? Do you need a flat tire repaired? Are you looking for a $45 alignment and the lowest prices in the state? Come to Perez Tire Center located in the city of Bridgeport. At Perez Tire Center, we take pride in our selection and service. We are never short on inventory, and we give you the best guaranteed lowest prices up front. At Perez Tire Center, we slash the competition and will beat the other guys. Financing is available and no credit check is needed. We also install batteries and tires on recreational vehicles, trailers, and motorcycles. If you need it, we got it. Perez Tire Center is open 7 days per week, located at 72 Knowlton Street in the great city of Bridgeport, Connecticut.
Spare over auto glass repair. For rapid, reliable auto glass replacement and repair, trust Bridgeport Auto Glass with over 25 years experience. We do all glass replacement, windshields, mirrors, door glass, sunroofs. For cars and a wide variety of trucks, we'll get you back on the road fast. Same day and mobile service available. Our fully licensed technicians can come to you. Serving both New Haven and Fairfield counties, credit cards and all insurance accepted. Bridgeport Auto Glass, skilled, efficient and affordable.
Hi, welcome to Aces Bail Bonds.
Do you need information regarding bail bonds and the bail bond process? Contact us at Aces Bail Bonds, where we are happy to give you a free bail consultation. You are in capable hands with our reputable agency. For fast, reliable bail bond service, get out of jail fast with Aces Bail Bonds. You can save time and money by calling ahead. We'll have the forms ready for you, with everything handled privately, discreetly, and confidentially at our office. For fast, reliable bail bond service, call Aces Bail Bonds now.
All right, and welcome back to Super League Entertainment. I'm your host, Jason Rodriguez. We are back here in the Super League Entertainment studio located in the great city of Bridgeport, Connecticut. And tonight we're having a good time with personal trainer and bodybuilder, professional bodybuilder. And you'll see in a moment why I say professional bodybuilder when I bring Joel Rodriguez onto the camera. But with that said, man, listen, click that share button and share this broadcast into your timeline, all right? Let's get back to it, Joel. Boom! That's what I said. Professional bodybuilder.
You see it?
Boom, boom, boom. Hold on. Let me try that. Let's do it together, Joel.
I remember when I was a kid, I used to see the wrestlers do that. I was like, man, how did they do that?
Hold on. That's so cool. Let me put that camera. Oh, there it is. You see it?
A little bit. I used to
watch the wrestlers be like, man, how they do that? That's so cool. And I'd be over there going, nah, look at that. It's easy.
Oh, man. So, Joel.
Yes.
We are back from the commercial break. And we've been having a good time so far, man. Definitely. And how you feeling?
I feel great, man. I feel amazing. I'm alive, man. Another day above ground is a blessing.
That's right. And now, people that are watching right now, they're probably saying, yo, that dude is huge. Is he on steroids? Is he juicing?
Yeah, that's a normal.
What would your response be to that, Joel?
Nah, this is called hard work and dedication. I said it before in the last show. This is hard work and dedication. When people assume you take stuff, it's then people envy. That's hate. Instead of giving you credit, because a good looking physique shows the skills of a hard working man or woman. Not just because women work out too, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So because you see me built this way, automatically, he's taking steroids. And whether I take them or not, it's my body. I do what I want with it. Uh-huh. At the end of the day, if I would decide to do anything like that, I know the repercussions to it.
Yeah.
Like I said, I respect the sport. Bodybuilding is a sport. I love it. I don't care what those guys say. That is their business. Mm-hmm. I'm not never going to down any of them because they take this and that. But like I said, it's their business and it's their body. And that is their job, to look that way. Yes. This is my job, is just to make people look better and feel better about themselves.
Yeah. So how hard is it to remain dedicated to what it is that you believe in?
Oh, it's very hard because, you know, sometimes I have my moments when I get up and like, man, you know what? I'm getting tired of doing this. I just want to sit back, eat cake, and get a belly and just live. Yeah. It's hard. But, you know, it, like I said, it's a mental thing. Everything's in the mind. The mind is very powerful. Mm-hmm. And I work so hard to where I'm at now to reach a lot of goals that I still, believe it or not, even built this way, like we were talking about earlier in the mirror, I still look in the mirror and be like, wow, man. Did all this work and I feel like crap, you know. I don't feel right.
Yeah,
my abs ain't popping the way I want. My legs ain't big, and it's just, you know, it's body dysmorphic syndrome, man. We all get it. Women get it, man. Get you see, especially women, they get it the most because they perfectionists. They they're not happy. Sometimes you be like, you look great. No, I feel fat. You know, men go through it too. It's not just women. Men go through it too.
So looking the way you look. Mm-hmm. So you're telling me when you take your shirt off, you look in the mirror, you find little, you know, little areas where you're like, flaws. You know what, this don't look good.
Yeah, I find flaws. And it be all in your mind. It's all in your mind because at the end of the day, like I said, I work hard. I think I look great. Uh-huh. I feel great. The main thing with this lifestyle is health, man. It's not even about being big, about having muscles. You want to make sure the heart is right. You want to make sure you're eating right. Mm-hmm. You want to make sure that, you know, you're not diabetic, etc. The looks come with it.
Yeah.
If you put in the time, the muscles come with it. But my main, number one priority is healthy. I want to be healthy at all times. And, you know, as we said the last time, a lot of people still may not know. I look like this and I felt healthy. I felt great. And, dude, I had a heart attack.
That's right.
I had a heart attack. I had heart surgery last year. And a lot of people don't know that because I'm not the one to broadcast my business on social media. My business is my business. That's why it's called personal business. Mm-hmm. I don't post up me sitting in the hospital bed with, oh, pray for me and all that. A lot of people really don't care, man, to be honest. Me, I had a heart attack. And I look good, man. Like I said it before as well. The car is nice. Like, it's like buying a car. Oh, it looks nice. Rims are shining, but the motor shot. Mm-hmm. I had heart disease. I didn't even know it. Mm. And today, man, God is good, man. Today I went to the doctor for a checkup, man. And it's been a year since my heart attack. And he said, get off the medication, man. He said,
wow.
I don't have to take it anymore because I'm pretty much recovered, man.
Wow.
And I do have stents. Thank you. I'm happy. I do have stents. I always get tired of taking medication. But I do have stents in my heart. I have stents in my heart. I had heart surgery. But again, and I didn't know that I wasn't healthy. And us as men, especially men, we don't like doctors. Mm-hmm. We felt some type of pain. We'd be like, it's probably heartburn or it's just a cramp. No, I was having them symptoms and I fought it for 2 days. I almost died. Mm. Sat in ICU for a week. And this is why I push health even more now. Even like, especially cardio is a big thing. This is a big muscle that a lot of men, I hate running. God bless you. If you're a runner, oh, God bless. I hate running. But we have to work the heart, man. That is an important muscle. It's like your car. When you turn on the car, you got to warm it up.
That's right.
You have to warm up. You got valves and all that stuff in there to get that blood pumping. But through the grace of God, man, he saved my life, man. Here I am. He gave me another chance.
Wow. And people will look at you, you know, the shape you're in, and they would think that your health is 100%.
Yeah, I thought it was until I ended up in that situation. So it goes to show you, just because you look healthy doesn't mean you are. It could be somebody out of shape and go to the doctor, and the doctor be like, you're healthy as an ox. Mm. And he's probably, you know, got more body fat than me. And I went, and they said I wasn't healthy. I said I had heart disease.
Wow.
Clot arteries.
Wow.
But I'm good. I'm here now. I feel better than ever. And it's a learning experience, and you know.
And you're still pushing it to the limit.
Oh, man. I started off, yeah, I push even harder. Mm. Even because I know my body.
Yeah.
They know the heart, but I know my body. Mm-hmm. And I know what I can do, what I can't. And when I put my mind through it, I could do whatever I want, man. My body is my temple. Mm. like I said, I can be fat, I can be skinny, I can be cut, I can be lean, I can be a lot of things, because my mind will allow me to do that, and I believe in all that.
I wanna jump back in momentarily to in regards to your clients, right, the clientele that you serve. But really quick, I just want to take a look on Facebook. We got quite a few people that are watching, and I just want to look at the comments that people are leaving on here, right?
So positive vibes, I'm telling you right now.
So we got someone named Sensa Nova. You know who that is?
Who?
Swit.
You saying
it's a very interesting name. Velana Samsonova.
Nah.
I don't know, but she's giving you a thumbs up, Joel. She's giving you a thumbs up.
I appreciate that. Thank you.
We have April Baca. She got the hand up in the air, letting you know you're doing a good job.
Appreciate that. Thank you.
Another gentleman we're going to acknowledge who always tunes in every Tuesday night. Stanley Rogers, we truly appreciate you being out there, always tuning in.
Thank you, bro.
And he wrote on here, I think you look relaxed too much, Jason. I guess I'm just relaxed.
This is what happens, man. We're friends. We're like brothers.
I'm not relaxed tonight.
And you're a veteran now. This is a vet. This is your show. You're a vet. This ain't nothing new, man.
Stanley, man, is all about relaxing, man.
That's right.
Relaxation is key. It's important. All
he
right.
Making me nervous.
And then he followed up his statement with, "You're in the zone. You better believe we're in the zone tonight."
That's right, man.
And also, this someone else on here named Luz Rodan Roman. She's asking you, Joel, do you have a program for women over 60 years old? Just asking, she says.
Definitely. Definitely. Oh, yes. Yes. You can modify a lot. Man, I'm great. Trust me. If you're interested, you know, you always message me or email me. Towards the end of the show, I'll give out that information. But yes, I have plans for 60-year-old. I have plans for 12, 13, 14. If you're 8 months, I give you a plan. It's not a game, man. I'm so humble, but I am really good at what I do. I'm good, man. I love it. I love it. It is not cockiness. Please don't take this as a cockiness. I have to believe in my program.
Yep.
If I don't, nobody else will.
Yep.
And I know I'm good at what I do.
And the same gentleman, again, he wrote two more comments in here. So I'm just going to acknowledge his comments that he wrote. But that's something I like to do, especially for you guys that are watching every week. Stanley Rogers wrote on here, pure respect, 100. Good for you, Joel. Stay the way you are. Trust me, there is no imperfections basically on you.
I appreciate that. Thank
you,
brother. You
have done what you have set out to do. Be happy inside as well, Joel. Well, no more medication, pal.
Yeah. Oh, man. Pills was killing me, man.
And then he concluded by saying, stick to your routine. And we already know that. You're going to stick to your routine.
Man. That's a must.
Yeah.
A must. I don't break it. I'll just change it.
That's right.
Change it.
So I wanted you to just talk about your clients really quick. And what I mean by that is, what kind of clients do you like to work with? Let's say I'm 140 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure that you love to work with a person that at that weight. But let's say I come to you and I'm like 365.
I would love to work with that person even better, because I love the challenge. And I know that I can get he or she to where they want to be. I'm basically just a coach.
Uh-huh.
Everything's gonna depend all to the client, because at the end of the day, it's up to the client. When you're at the gym, it's my job to make you work, make you sweat. But I can't monitor you what you do when you go home. So a lot of people nowadays spend a lot of money on trainers and always blaming the trainer. It's not right. It's not. Yes, I will never badmouth a trainer, but you got some people that don't know what they're doing.
Mm.
But you got a lot of them that are really good, and people blame them. Oh, I spent thousands of dollars and I didn't lose no weight. Let's be realistically, if you didn't lose no weight, it's because you're not following the routine. You're not following the regimen that the trainer gave you.
Mm-hmm.
You're eating, let's be realistically, you're eating like crap.
You know, when I used to go to the gym,
right,
I would see personal trainers with their clients. Now, tell me if I'm wrong, but I've seen trainers trying to train three people at one time. They're bouncing around, you know? Is that okay? Is that the right
thing
to do?
It's okay. It's if you have a program, you can do a circuit, because I can do a boot camp class. I can do a class. I can train 10 people at one time. It's all if you're good at what you do, you just make them do circuits.
Okay.
It's possible.
Okay.
This person will do this, you will do this. You time them, because you can't count, because if you count for them, everybody's going to be off.
Mm-hmm.
You give them all a minute and you be like, "Go." And you time them. So if he's doing tricep press, she's doing squats, and he's doing bicycle crunches for a minute. Once the minute I stop, Now you're going to do what she does. He's going to do what she does. So it's possible, yes.
So how about those other trainers that I see with their clients? They're sitting there like this.
Yeah. You don't want that.
I mean, first of all, you need to motivate me, man.
Yeah, man.
And I don't see that motivation in some of them.
No, I see it a lot. No, that's actually, I find that disrespect to my profession, because when people pay you, they pay you for a reason. Mm-hmm. And they don't just come to you because they want to lose weight. They need motivation. You're not going to just, I'm not just going to take your money and sit there and be like, all right, go do this. You almost done? All right, let's go. Mm-hmm. Do this. No, that's horrible. That's horrible. No, you don't do that. That's not a good trainer. That's just somebody that's in it for the money. I'm not in it just for the money. Mm-hmm. I'm in it for the lifestyle. I'm in it to change people's life. And I want you to live long.
Yeah. There's someone on here. Well, I'm not going to say just someone. Someone that we both, I believe, know. I know. Michael Alisea, I want to thank you for tuning in tonight. He just left us a comment. And he wrote on here, what's up, brothers? Hector Rosa and Michael here watching. Oh, okay. So Hector Rosa and Michael are watching right now. And he said on here, Joel, he said, Joel was the man. His
thank
work
you, brother. I appreciate
is priceless. And he's one of the best trainers around.
Man, man, God bless you, brother. Thank you. I mean it a lot, man. I take that comment very respectfully and humble. I'm very humble for that. Thank you so much, and I appreciate that. Sometimes it's good to hear that because you don't never hear it.
Yep.
I say it, but it's good to hear from somebody else. Dude, you're a great trainer. You're a beast and all that. And it's well-deserved and well-earned, and it's humbling.
Yeah.
It's humbling. It just goes to show that you are doing your job. Sometimes I feel like, damn, am I slacking? Mm-hmm. I mean, am I not doing what I'm supposed to do? So to hear words from somebody else, it's kind words like that, man, it means a lot. So thank you so much, brother. I really appreciate it.
And also,
that,
thank
man.
You for tuning in. I truly appreciate that. Yes, with that said, we're going to take another commercial break, all right?
Definitely.
So for you guys that are watching right now on Facebook, YouTube, don't go anywhere. I'm your host, Jason Rodriguez. We got one of the best personal trainers and bodybuilders throughout the state of Connecticut here with us tonight, giving us some freebie tips, all right? We'll be right back momentarily from a commercial break. Thank you for tuning in.
And to be honest, I'm Rich Restaurant.
Looking for custom wheels? Looking for quality and professional service? Do you need a flat tire repaired? Are you looking for a $45 alignment and the lowest prices in the state? Come to Perez Tire Center located in the city of Bridgeport. At Perez Tire Center, we take pride in our selection and service. We are never short on inventory, and we give you the best guaranteed lowest prices up front. At Perez Tire Center, we slash the competition and will beat the other guys. Financing is available and no credit check is needed. We also install batteries and tires on recreational vehicles, trailers, and motorcycles. If you need it, we got it. Perez Tire Center is open 7 days per week, located at 72 Knowlton Street in the great city of Bridgeport, Connecticut.
Hi, welcome to Aces Bail Bonds.
Do you need information regarding bail bonds and the bail bond process? Contact us at Aces Bail Bonds, where we are happy to give you a free bail consultation. You are in capable hands with our reputable agency. For fast, reliable bail bond service, get out of jail fast with Aces Bail Bonds. You can save time and money by calling ahead. We'll have the forms ready for you, with everything handled privately, discreetly, and confidentially at our office. For fast, reliable bail bond service, call Aces Bail Bonds now.
All right, and welcome back to Super League Entertainment. I'm your host, Jason Rodriguez, and we are back from a commercial break. And we are so excited to be back here in the studio in the great city of Bridgeport, Connecticut, with a really good friend of mine, his personal trainer and professional bodybuilder, Mr. Joel Rodriguez. Joel.
Yes.
We're back from commercial break. We've been on a roll in the zone, baby.
Man, I'm relaxed, man. I can sleep here.
We've been in the zone. And let's see. Anybody else watch any other comments on here? No other comments. Oh. Oh, okay, Stanley Rogers again. I mean, he's plugged in, man.
I said, hey, get it while you can, brother.
And Stanley is saying, thank you for the shout-out, Jason and Joel.
Thank you, brother.
You look after yourself, brother. Take care, guys. And Stan needing his peace in 100. Anyhow, we truly appreciate Stanley Rogers for tuning in. Sometimes it's hard to read the comments that people leave.
People don't write no more. People just abbreviate everything. Yeah. They don't even say okay. They just put K or what is WTH.
You're right.
So it's like, what? And they expect you to, what does that mean? Oh, you're illiterate. Did you know what you just spelled right now?
So, you know, I have another question for you, Joel. I wanted to talk momentarily about supplements. Right. You know, we were talking about that when we were off camera.
Right.
You know, these companies and manufacturers out there, they make all these different type of supplements, mm-hmm. like PumpTech, Gacket, nitric oxide, all these different types of proteins, and they put people like you that are diesel as hell on the cover,
right.
So that so they can bait you, so they can pull mm-hmm. you in. Mm-hmm. So my question is, these supplements out there that they put out, GNC. You can't walk by GNC and not see an image of a person like yourself.
Right.
Do these supplements really work? And do we really need these type of supplements in our body in order to be in good shape?
Well, let's be honest. Like, I keep it. Like I said, this is what we're here for, right?
Uh-huh.
You know, to be 100. Like, a lot of these supplements do work and a lot of them don't. Mm-hmm. But if we eat the way we should eat and get the proper nutrients that our body needs, you technically don't need supplements mm-hmm. at all. Supplements are made to replace what we don't eat mm-hmm. because us being human, a lot of us, we're lazy. Instead of eating some protein, we'll rather drink the protein.
That's right.
Instead of getting a stimulant to have energy, we'll rather drink a pre-workout. But you can get that from drinking coffee, because all it is, a pre-workout is loaded with caffeine.
Mm.
Nitric oxide is you produce more oxygen to your body through your blood to get that pump, get the vein. Eat kale. If we eat the way we should, believe me, these supplement companies will not make money at all.
Mm.
But because we're in a society and a culture that we're lazy to prep and do this, so we go spend $50 on a gallon of whey protein, $40 on a pre-workout, nitric oxide, stuff like that.
Uh-huh.
But does it work? A lot of it does, and a lot of it don't.
You know, let me tell you something about nitric oxide. I remember some years ago when I was like crazy into working out. I was way bigger, you know, bigger person.
Yeah.
And I was taking Gacket, PumpTech, and I was taking nitric oxide. And I did a second workout. I took all my supplements, post-workout supplements. And one of those supplements was nitric oxide.
Right.
And let me tell you something, man. I lay down. And I swear to goodness, because of that supplement I took, I stopped breathing for a minute.
It's possible, man. It's possible.
I mean,
it's possible. A lot of the stuff, and then it requires you have to drink a lot of water no matter what. Mm-hmm. And plus, you can take all the supplements you want. If you're not working out, it's not going to work for you. You're wasting. They're very expensive.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to put them to use. You have to work out. Again, the protein, if you eat chicken, you eat fish. I'm not a vegan. I eat meat. So I'm sorry. No disrespect to vegans, but I'm a meat eater. You get your proteins from that.
Uh-huh.
You know, spinach and stuff like that. So because, like I said, we live in a culture and a society that we're too lazy to eat stuff like that, we'd rather just pay for it and drink it.
Mm-hmm. You're right.
That's it. Because like I said, if you, and again, like all these vitamins people taking all that, our body's only going to accept but so much.
Mm-hmm.
The rest, you're going to, you know, use the bathroom, you're gonna pee it all out.
Yeah.
If you ever take the multivitamins, they come with the fish oil, the vitamin A, B, and all that. When you go to the bathroom, your urine is real yellow. Really, really. And you can smell it. You can smell the vitamin because your body took what it needs and the rest you wasted it. So if you take nitric oxide, then you're gonna drink a pre-workout. You're working two things together. And you're wasting your money because nitric oxide gives you a pump, gives you energy as well. Pre-workout, it's loaded with caffeine, and it gives you the same as well. So you mix the two compounds together. It's just a waste of money, man.
Yeah. Well, I'm
not saying don't buy it now. If that's totally up to you.
Yeah.
Like, but they are expensive.
They are expensive, and I'm going to admit, that nitric oxide.
I take supplements.
Yeah.
I sit here and tell you, I take supplements because I'm considered at times, I'm lazy when it comes to that.
Yeah.
But in the gym, I'm an animal.
I mean, I'm going to admit, that nitric oxide, man, it literally, legit, makes you feel like a beast.
It does.
I mean, it gives you a serious
your
pump.
Your veins pop out. Your
like, you can feel it flowing through your veins.
Yeah, it's all extra oxygen. But again, too much of it is bad for you.
Mm-hmm.
It can cause you to bleed and all that because too much kale is bad for you. Kale is good, but if you eat too much of it, uh-huh. it's really bad for you. If you eat too much or drink too much protein, it's harsh on your liver.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I was happy today when the doctor said I can get off the pills, because I went for blood work recently and my liver enzyme was through the roof, man. They were very high because I'm taking pills. I'm taking like 6-7 different pills a day on top of the supplements. So I stopped taking my supplements because I was taking too many pills, man. Eventually, man, I was going to damage my liver.
Mm.
So I just stopped. Now, and, you know, even today, the doctor was like, if you're taking any type of supplements, I advise you not to, because we still don't understand why you had the heart attack.
Yeah.
We're still trying to figure out you're healthy. We don't know why.
Mm-hmm.
We know you had heart disease, but that's the theory. There was the heart disease, but he said, honestly, we don't know. So please, he told me, stay off of it. And I haven't been taking it.
Yeah.
If I want to... pre-workout, I go to D&D or Starbucks, load up on
some coffee,
either coffee or a shot of espresso.
Okay,
it works just as much and it's natural.
Mm.
Like I said, if you take and drink and eat the natural foods, you don't need this stuff. But if we do that, then what? Why do they need to sell supplements for?
You know, there's someone on here watching on Facebook right now, Luis Carrasquillo, and he's asking you, Joel, how good is soup for you?
Soup?
Mostly the broth. So he's asking, how good is soup for you?
Well, I mean, I need a better question. I mean, not a better question, but like, what does he mean, how good? Because I just ate soup before I got here. Chicken soup. Now, if you're sick,
uh-huh.
It's good for your stomach and it settles your stomach and stuff like that.
I mean, he wrote on here, how good is soup for you? Mostly
it depends
broth.
What soup? Well, it depends what broth,
so
too.
So either Lipton soup, Campbell soup.
Because if you eat, like, if I listen, oh, it could be not.
It could be a joke, but I don't think it is.
It is a
joke, legit question.
Guess what? I still eat ramen soup.
Oh,
I was used to buy them by the cases back then. I buy them by the cases now.
You put you use the
sodium? No, I put a little bit, and that's high on salt.
Yeah, exactly.
That thing is high on salt. But guess what? That's something that I lived off for 10 years, man.
So
10 years because of the garbage food that you eat. Where I was at, it was just. Ramen, what it was, and I still eat. They be like, "You still eat ramen?" Yup, but I don't make more phone calls. I don't throw the chips in there. I don't throw the nachos. I don't do none of that stuff. But believe it or not, I still eat it.
So my question is, I wish I had something to throw. When you get ready to make that ramen, do you take the whole bag and slam it, bam, to break it up?
I used to. Now I'm home, so I'm gentle. Pom, pom,
are you gentle?
And then,
oh, so you classy now?
Yeah. Oh yeah. Come on, man. I'm bougie. But soup is good, man. Soup is good. And then another thing, like I drink, if whoever is watching, if you're having stomach issues, kombucha is good. I don't know if I'm saying it right, but y'all know what I mean. It has healthy, it's probiotic, it's good for your stomach. It has the, geez, I'm tongue-tied right now. But it's healthy, it's good for your stomach. It has the healthy bacteria. There you go.
So, Carrasquillo, Luis Carrasquillo responded on here, all right? And Carrasquillo, we truly appreciate you watching, man. Thank you for tuning in tonight, Luis Carrasquillo.
10 years of ramen soup, bro.
But Carrasquillo is, what he said on here was homemade soup, I guess.
Oh, nice.
I lost 35 pounds in 3 months. I guess what he's saying is he's been drinking chicken broth.
But what's going on? Oh, so you're basically, it's almost like juicing. It's good for you, depending, now is it organic? If it's not organic, then you know you got to be careful because it's going to be high in sodium.
Mm-hmm.
And you get high blood pressure, cholesterol, but... If you're eating soup, yeah, you're going to lose weight because it's like a liquid diet.
Uh-huh.
But don't get too caught up just eating that. You still need your protein, bro. You still need to eat your little carb. And that's carbs. Actually, that's complex. But I'm not a big, don't eat carb. I'm a big carb. I eat carbs. I just don't eat too much of it. But I eat carb. Before, on a leg day, I load up. Believe it or not, if I'm doing legs today, 9 o'clock in the morning, I'm eating rice, chicken. And it sounds crazy, but believe it or not, when I go to the gym,
mm-hmm.
I feel strong. I'm a monster because you need carbs for energy.
Yeah. So, with that said, Joel, We're going to go to our last commercial break. When we come back, you know what time it is, right?
Shotgun, baby.
Shotgun questions, baby. Hold on. All right. So when we come back, you guys that are watching right now live on Facebook, we're going to come back with the shotgun questions. We're going to hit Joel off with these simple little questions that sometimes are hard and complicated for a person to respond to. And I'm interested to find out what movie he likes the best. Don't say it yet, Joel, but we'll be right back momentarily. Don't go anywhere. Your host, Jason Rodriguez, with Joel Rodriguez at the Super League Entertainment Studio, bringing it to you live each and every Tuesday night. Stay tuned. We'll be right back momentarily.
With over 2 years of tradition, Rancho Paternal Brazilian Steakhouse offers the best premium steak cuts prepared with precision and served the authentic Brazilian way. We offer an extended salad bar, a select wine menu, amazing drinks and desserts, all in a cozy and relaxed environment so you can enjoy our delicious meats and service. And don't forget to visit our website for information about our catering services. It would be a pleasure to serve you. Rancho Paternal Brazilian Steakhouse, the authentic Brazilian churrasco.
Hi, welcome to Aces Bail Bonds.
Do you need information regarding bail bonds and the bail bond process? Contact us at Aces Bail Bonds, where we are happy to give you a free bail consultation. You are in capable hands with our reputable agency. For fast, reliable bail bond service, get out of jail fast with Aces Bail Bonds. You can save time and money by calling ahead. We'll have the forms ready for you, with everything handled privately, discreetly, and confidentially at our office. For fast, reliable bail bond service, call Aces Bail Bonds now.
All right, and welcome you guys back to Super League Entertainment. We are here live in the studio in the great city of Bridgeport, Connecticut. And we do this every Tuesday night. And we bring to you the best exclusive interviews throughout the state of Connecticut. And man, I get pumped up every time I got to come into the studio to be behind the camera. It's not easy to do this. Sitting on this hot seat right here is hard. But you know what? I love it. I enjoy it. It's my passion, and it's what I do. And if you know someone that has a special story, if you know someone that has a powerful story, someone that can sing, someone that can play an instrument, someone that can perform, a comedian, whatever the case may be, and you would like for them to be featured on our show, go onto our website, www.superleagueentertainment.com. Leave us a message. Leave us a comment right there on our website. And leave us their information, and we reach out to them. And hopefully we can get them here into our studio located in the city of Bridgeport, Connecticut, downtown Bridgeport, right across the street from the Bijou Theater. That's where we're located. So with that said, we are back with personal trainer and professional bodybuilder Joel Rodriguez, and we are about to hit him off with the shotgun questions. All right, so you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right, baby, so let's do it. I got a couple of shotgun questions for you, and the first one is, and you can't give me the same answers you gave me last time. First question, what is your favorite song?
My favorite song? Wow, there's so many. R&B or hip-hop?
Whatever, any song.
Well, I'm a big Tupac fan, so I'm going to say Tupac, one of the Tupacs. I'm not going to say what I said before, so I'll say Only God Can Judge Me.
Only God Can Judge Me. Yep, I know that song. That's actually a really good song. What's your favorite movie?
Well, I told you the last time was The Notebook, but I have a second favorite movie. So what? Don't judge me. Don't judge me. A second favorite movie, honestly? Oh, man. Can it be a cartoon?
Cartoon.
Toy
Story.
No, I like Chronicles of Narnia.
Chronicles of Narnia.
Yeah.
That's a good movie. I didn't see the whole thing. I seen only a portion of it. So
no, I love it. It's a great movie.
What's your favorite food? And we know you like to eat, brother.
Favorite food? Wow, man, yellow rice, man.
Yellow rice.
Yellow rice and chicken. Yes.
How about egg? Con huevito encima.
All that, man. I want to say pernil, but it's unhealthy. It's very unhealthy.
That pork ain't no good?
Oh, man. It takes too long to digest in your system.
What's your favorite sport?
Baseball.
All day?
Yeah, baseball, man. Red Sox.
Big Poppy.
Almost got killed. Man, stay out of Dominican Republic, bro.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, listen, man. The rumor is Big Papi was trying to kick it to a drug dealer's girl.
Wife. Yeah, that's what they say. Yeah, to his wife. So they paid. They beat the dude down too, man.
Yeah, they did.
And God bless him, man. Because from what I don't know him personally, but I hear he's a great guy. But still, you can't be fornicating with people's wife. You kidding me? I'll beat you down too, boy.
What's your favorite car?
Favorite car? Woo! I'm a BMW guy, man. I love BMW.
That's what you drive right now, right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Yeah.
Yep. That's Big Willie status.
Oh, no, I'm broke. That's another thing. Yeah, why is it that you can't, like, it's hard to run away from the stereotype.
Uh-huh.
Because just because I drive a nice car or I might have a few gold chains, why would you even approach me and be like, yo, put me on? What, with a 9-to-5? Because that's what I do.
Yep.
And I have more now than I had then when I thought I had.
Uh-huh.
A lot. What I thought I had a lot, I have less now, but it feels like more because it's a blessing. God has blessed me with what I have now, and I work for it so hard. And I love it.
And there's nothing better than enjoying what you have worked for.
Oh, my God. You don't know the good feeling it is when I go drop that money on this that I work for.
Uh-huh.
It's amazing, man. And it lasts as long, and it's a great feeling. It's a great feeling. What's the next question, man?
Next question. What do you like to read?
Ooh, man, I told you before, I'm a big, I used to be a bookworm. Well, I used to read a lot Donald Goins' book. So if you guys are familiar with Donald Goins, Daddy Cool, you know what I mean. If you ever been where I've been, you know who Donald Goins is.
Okay. And what's the favorite thing you like to do the most? Besides working out,
the favorite thing? Relax, enjoy peace and quiet. I'm, believe it or not, I am my best company. Me, alone.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not that type. I mean, I love being with people and have company. But if I didn't have that, it wouldn't bother me because I love me. I love being with me. I like to relax. I like to just relax. I like to sleep, which I barely get. But I'm my best company. So I would like to say just not doing anything for at least a day.
Mm-hmm.
Just enjoying the day, enjoying the view.
Okay. What's your favorite place to visit?
Favorite place to visit, man? I would love to visit, honestly. Because I'm not a big traveling guy.
Mm-hmm.
But I wouldn't mind going to, Turks and Caicos. Or St. Barts and stuff like that.
Okay. Other than your profession,
mm-hmm.
what you currently do right now, if you had to do it all over again, what would that thing be that you would do?
Me? Man, I would have stood in school, man. I would have stood in school, finished school, and probably try to, because I was a good baseball player, man. I probably would try to pursue a career in that.
Mm-hmm.
But definitely, man, I screwed up, man. So if you guys are listening, if youngins, whatever, please stay in school, man. Because believe it or not, I'm going to school now. I'm trying to undo what I did. Like, I've never graduated, so I'm going to school. I'm trying to get my GED, you know?
That's good.
And I don't care. Yes, and at this age, because school is important, mm-hmm. and I want my son and my kids to see that education is important. So just because I screwed up, I'm not allowing them to do it. And you're never too old to learn. So
that's right.
I'm still learning.
And I'll keep it real.
I wasn't embarrassed to say that either, because some people, I'm trying to get my GED, man. I'm in the process of doing that now. And it's probably going to be one of the highlights of my life when I get that diploma, when I graduate.
That's good. And it's going to be
I never wore a cap and gown before. So to even wear that, even though I got it at this late stage in the game, man, it's never too late. So
never too late.
No. So can't wait. I'm excited about
that. And in case if you don't know, I myself have a GED.
Yeah.
You know?
And look at your career. And you turned out well. Got your own studio from where we came from to mm-hmm. now, man. It's amazing. So, mm-hmm. you know, that if I can do it all over again, I would have stood my knucklehead ass in school, man. Pardon my friend. I would have stood in school.
Get that edumacation.
Yes.
Edumacation. All it's right? Very get important. That GED.
And you won't be texting the way we text now. K. What?
You know, the thing that's really interesting is that for you to get your GED, it's free. It's free. You can go to Central High School. You can go to wherever adult education is available.
Yeah, I go to one in Shelton.
Yep.
I go to one showing.
And I'm not sure if you ever heard this term before, but GED has a purpose. It has a meaning behind it. It means good enough diploma.
That's right. And believe it or not, it sounds crazy, and it's a hard test.
Uh-huh. It is a hard test.
It's one of the hardest tests to take, believe it or not, besides college. It's not easy. So you can say, oh, yeah. No, it's not easy.
Mm-hmm. Get that education. Real talk. Get it. It's free. Especially if you want to advance yourself and get ahead. Go and get your GED.
Definitely.
If heaven exists, all right, what would you like to hear God say to you, Joel, when you arrive at the pearly gates?
Welcome home. Welcome home.
And finally, the last question.
Sure.
Who's your favorite boxer?
Come on, man. Mike Tyson, man.
Iron Mike?
Iron Mike, man. It was then, it's still now, regardless of what he been through, the man was an animal, man. And what? When boxing was boxing.
Uh-huh.
No, I mean, I think it's a bunch, no disrespect to any fighters, it's just like entertainment. But back then, boxing was the deal, man. And Mike Tyson was the man. And nobody could beat Mike.
That's right.
Then he started, you know what happens. You start doing, hanging out and listening to other people. You ruin yourself. But he's still my guy.
That's right.
Still my guy.
And you know, Joel, I had a good time tonight.
I did too, man.
And I truly appreciate you coming down to the studio. And, you know, this was part two to the part one we did months ago.
Right.
And I think part two was just as good or even better.
I believe so too.
Than the first one.
Before we go, I just want to send a shout out.
Yep.
If you're from the Ansonia area, hit up Tisha. She's starting her own fitness gym. It's called Fitting In. They're going to have personal trainers, meal preps, shakers, juicers, Zumba. You name it, she's going to have it. If anybody, any Zumba instructors or any personal trainer looking for work, you can hit her up at 203-982-3011. Or fittinginllc@yahoo.com or Tisha Lee 1981@yahoo.com. The gym is going to be amazing. She's thinking about opening up and by pushing to open up. Grand opening August 31st, opening August 17th. Again, it's Fitting In LLC. Check her out, man. And if you got any questions, like I shoot her an email, or if any of you guys didn't get it, shoot me an email. Mm-hmm. I'm at jrodriguezpf@yahoo.com or on Instagram, Fitness Is My Life 76. You can DM me, send me requests, any questions, interested in any personal training. Facebook, please, if you instant message me, be serious about training, because this is not a game for me. This is my livelihood. I will teach you whatever you need to know, what you want. I will help you to the best of my ability, but I do not redeem free services. I do not do free services. And on that note, God bless you all. Thank you all for whoever tuned in. I really appreciate it. Jason, thank you.
No, it's definitely. Thank you for coming down.
No, but, I'm honored to be here, man.
Hold on.
Thank you so much. Before you go,
because you're not going to come on my show and my platform,
oh, man,
you know, with the tank top shirt and
oh, push your limits.
Hold on.
This shirt was given to me by a very, very special friend.
Hold on. Let's take a survey.
Yeah.
Of the people that are watching on Facebook right now, and I want you to tell me a competition between me and Joel Rodriguez. All right. Who's stronger?
I'll just give you my forearm. that's not no chop. Oh,
bang!
My goodness. I'm just kidding, man. Well, I appreciate
hold on,
you.
Hold
Thank
on, hold on.
So much,
no, but before you,
man,
go, no, no. Before you blessing, go, yes. You just got to hit the, you know, all your videos that you put on Instagram. Before you start, you always do. Like Big Poppy.
Let's go.
And then you.
He stole that from me. And that's why that happened to him. He stole my stuff. No, I'm just kidding. No, that's my thing, man. I'm focused and I'm ready to destroy stuff. That's my goal. So I just hit him with the.
Well, woman. Bang! Do it again. That's how we're going to close this out with you. Wow. Excellent, Joel. Well, listen, brother, truly appreciate the opportunity. Thank you for coming to the studio.
Thank you, brother.
All right. And, you know, keep doing what you're doing.
I appreciate that.
Keep grinding, keep shining.
Will do.
And keep pushing the limit.
Always.
All right.
Man. Thank you.
And listen, for you guys that are watching right now via Facebook, I just truly, truly, truly Thank you for tuning in tonight. We had a good time with professional bodybuilder and professional personal trainer, Joel Rodriguez. If you want some more information on Joel, you can either go onto our website at www.supereliteentertainment.com, or you can go and check out Joel Rodriguez on Instagram and also on Facebook. If you want his services, all you got to do is hit him up, make arrangements. Joel will contact you back immediately. And at some point, you'll be able to make arrangements so that you both can meet up and he can discuss his training plan with you. He's one of the best in the state of Connecticut. There's no other greater than Joel Rodriguez. And that's coming from me.
Yeah, right? I appreciate it.
There's plenty of other personal trainers out there.
Thank you.
No, there's other personal trainers out there, and I'm not going to knock any of them. But the one that I co-sign and the one that I recommend is Joel Rodriguez. So listen.
Appreciate that. Thank you.
Again, Joel, thank you for coming into the Super Elite Entertainment Studio.
Thank
we had a great time tonight. And I want to thank each and every one of you that are watching right now live. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for sharing this live broadcast onto your timeline. And also thank you for leaving us comments and asking us questions. We will be back next Tuesday night at 7 o'clock. We do this every Tuesday night. And again, until then, I'm your host, Jason Rodriguez. Thank you for tuning in. And we will see you next week. Same time, same channel, right here from Super Elite Entertainment Studio in the great city of Bridgeport, Connecticut. God bless.
This show is brought to you by Perez Tire Center, Aces Bail Bonds, Miranda & Sons Automotive, Bridgeport Auto Glass, Ramirez Spanish Restaurant, Tito's Barbershop, JC Tire Center, Rancho Patanal Brazilian Restaurant, and Luz de Paz Funeral Home.